minutes or so, maybe a little bit longer, just going through what we mean by the Scottish Qualifications Authority and what qualifications look like now in the current landscape. So there's been some changes even within the past 12 months or so. And I'll also talk about progression pathways and how we can link in with college, with university, and also with the world of work. Currently, the Scottish Qualifications Authority coordinator is actually Mr. Kenny, who's unfortunately at a family funeral today. I am currently no longer in this role, although I have been previously, so I've just stepped in to cover this. So if in the future you have any queries about qualifications or anything, it would be Mr. Kenny you would ask for, and he'd hopefully be able to answer your questions after tonight. So the first thing I'm going to show you is to do with actually secondary school and where we place ourselves. Obviously you start off S1 to S3 with what's known as now as the broad general education, and that's where we have something called the experiences and outcomes coming through Curriculum for Excellence that you may have heard about in the press, and that was launched getting on for 10 years ago now. And that's an entitlement that all pupils have to cover every single subject area up till the end of third year. So that means you shouldn't really be limiting your options too much in any school in Scotland. In S1 to S3, so you get experience of art, of music, of drama, and also your traditional subjects, maths, English, etc. To that, and that's up to what we'd know as level 3 minimum. But there'll also be some pupils that'll move forward to level 4, which is starting to link in to some of the national qualifications. All schools in Scotland will provide some limited elements of choice, which is again coming from government guidance, and that's allowing us pupils to specialise in the areas that they may be interested in. So for example, you might have a pupil who's particularly skilled in performing arts and in drama, and they may choose to specialise in our school at the end of first year in perhaps music or drama and get a bit more expertise from a subject specialist in that area. Alternatively, you might have a pupil who's really into cooking shows and television, love making meals for their parents, etc., and they might specialise in home economics. But even if you were to choose something in the junior phase, S1 to S3, it's still not really limiting your options as you go further up the school. So for example, if you were to have chosen music, in the course and the way it's been designed in the broad general education, you would also cover some of the elements of drama as well. So if when it came up to fourth year, you actually think, I wish I'd actually chosen drama, you've not closed off that pathway. You can still choose that as one of your 6 subject choices when you come into fourth year. And that's what's on the board there on the left-hand side, that broad general education, S1 to S3. Then if we follow that arrow up, we then have the senior phase, which is what starts at S4 to S6. And in this school, again following government guidance, like most schools in Scotland, we do have S4 to S6 senior stage. And that means that you could be in an English classroom in fourth year with fifth year or sixth year pupils. And that's just to broaden out the subject choice and the range of options that pupils have got in all of that senior stage, S4 to S6. And within that, we offer national qualifications at national 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 level. And I'll come back to those in a minute because that might be terms that some of you are unfamiliar with. But also still within the qualifications that we offer, there's hires, which is what we'd have sat when we were at school, and also potentially advanced hires, which is also leading towards the kind of level of work that you'll be faced if you go into university education. Okay. And what's on the board there? It's just a little probably for you to read fully, especially if you're at the back. But that's what we call the qualifications framework. And what ties into this at the left-hand side in the purple is the Scottish Qualifications Authority and the qualifications that they offer. And in this left-hand column, we'll see that they're actually given numbers, and it starts at National 1 at the bottom, all the way up to what we call Level 7, which is as high as we would offer in any secondary school within Scotland. But then after Level 7, those levels don't actually stop within this framework. They go all the way up to 12 and actually even 13. And if you look at the right-hand side in the kind of dark blue, that's where we get into higher education institutions like universities. And at the level 12, that's where we talk about a doctoral degree and that kind of level. But you see, even at university level, they fit within this framework. So if you were to go to university and study for a degree, you would have to be qualified up to what we call level 10. So even people doing national awards at level 1 are still within this particular framework. And this framework existed when we were in school. It probably probably not something you were necessarily familiar with. And just to kind of backtrack a little bit from what I was showing you there on the board, we've got 1 to 7 here, which, as I explained, is what we offer within a secondary school environment in Scotland. And on that light blue side, obviously, what perhaps you might be familiar with from when you were at school. I am in a position, having done my qualifications starting off in 1986, where I have some standard grades and some O grades on my CV. So some of this, anyone do O grades? Yeah, a few of you. So O grades would have been up to level 4. That's where O grades would have gone. I did actually drop them off the slides from previous years, but I should have left them on perhaps. So Access 1, Access 2, then Foundation at Standard Grade, or what was also known as Access 3 for some pupils, then Standard Grade General at 4, Standard Grade Credit at 5, and also Intermediate 2, which came in a few years after Standard Grade, but then Higher and Advanced Higher still there at 6 and 7. So just moving down the green column, which is what we currently offer, Advanced Higher still there at number 7. It's got new in brackets because there was some changes to assessment arrangements, and I'll come back to that in a second. The new Higher, still at level 6, and you'll see National 5 there is the equivalent of a credit at Standard Grade or Intermediate 2 course. And then National 4, the equivalent of a General at Standard Grade, so still a worthwhile qualification to have. And then National 3, the equivalent of a Foundation course. And in most cases, we wouldn't have many pupils at all going much lower than a National 3 course. And even then, only a small number. It tends to be National 4 qualifications and above. And the majority of pupils in fourth year will be studying National 5 and above as well. Okay. And again, just the problem with using screens as we are tonight, that possibly you won't be able to read. If you look at school, it's a flat line there. You've got broad general education, which I've explained, then the Nationals 4 and National 5, and then Higher's. And that's the most common route that we would expect pupils to follow within school. But you'll need to see beneath that, and this is something you'll hear a little bit more about when you talk to NSCOL and the college courses, you'll see that some of the courses they offer, for example, NPA in business, that's the equivalent of a National 5. Also, when you come to the HNC units in business, which is the next progression for that course, or also foundation apprenticeships, which you'll hear about in one of the talks tonight, that's the equivalent of Higher, so that's the equivalent of a level 6 course. So these courses from the college are fitting within the system and that framework. And then further over to the right, where we've got the university coming in, both University of Aberdeen and Robert Gordon's, who are both here tonight on hand to talk to you, you'll see where their courses can potentially progress from those college courses. You'll see, for example, following the college line, there'll be HNC in accounting, but that also links to BA Accounting and Finance. And that's where there's different routes to university and higher and further education now, compared to when I was at school, and even compared to 4 or 5 years ago. Where you can do what's called a 2-2-2, which is actually starting off on a strand, which might be a strand that's actually college, but depending on how an individual could get on with that strand, they could move forward and actually jump into different stages of their courses at university, whether that's University of Aberdeen or Robert Gordon. And also in this example, you can also see moving down towards this area here, where we can fit into a master's in accountancy and finance. And there's courses above in college that will move on. But eventually you'll get to the point over here where you can leave to go to work from this point here with the HND, or there's links further down where it would just purely be university that would offer courses up towards that level 10 kind of area from the framework. Any questions about that kind of framework and where the qualifications fit in so far, as I'm about to talk more a little bit about assessment and moderation activities? Anyone got any questions so far? So really that, to kind of summarise where we're at with this framework, it's just to point out that although the terminology of qualifications have changed somewhat in recent years, we're still fitting within this framework and matching the kind of level of complexity of courses to something that we were familiar with when we were at school as well. Okay, so just to kind of come back to the course choice process itself, so fourth year pupils, they'll be going through the course choice process and choosing a total of 6 subjects, which is English and maths and four others. And obviously, as I've said, these will be a National 3, National 4 and National 5 level. If you're here as a fourth year and a fifth year pupil, you'll be choosing 5 subjects, either at National 5 or higher level in most cases, and also a subject from our wider achievement column. And if there's any pupil, any parents of pupils in fifth year, you'd be choosing in most cases 4 subjects at either advanced higher, higher, or National 5, and also an extra choice from a wider achievement column. And in Mrs. Wilson's presentation, she'll talk a little bit more about the options that are available and how that would work within the course choice process. And just to kind of come back to assessment, quality assurance and moderation. Now, all assessments that take place in classes are quality assured and moderated. And what that means, if a classroom teacher is assessing a piece of work for something that's for a Scottish qualifications course, that would potentially be reassessed and looked at as a team within the department to make sure there's consistency of marking and consistency of approach across the whole subject. And that's replicated in every subject within the school and the same in every school across Scotland. And further to that, these standards would also be shared with colleagues across the city and across the country, again to make sure those standards are the same, just to give that validity towards the courses that we're offering within school. And that's especially important for the National 4 courses. They don't actually have any examinations. So if you're a National 4 pupil, all the assessment takes place internally within classes. And we'd be verified by the Scottish Qualifications Authority to kind of send information over what subjects we're looking at in particular years, and they'll come and visit us or ask to send information away, and that's to confirm that our standards are at the right level. And to date, and also from being Scottish Qualifications Authority coordinator in the school, there's never been any issues or questions over the standards of marking and the procedures that we follow within this school. In the other courses, there'll be a number of internal assessments that take place. And this is something that's changed in recent years. Until this year, all National 5 and higher courses have what were known as units. For two reasons, just there we are, but also for me, not for you. Just for two reasons, they were taken away. One was for workload for teachers, and the other one was for workload for pupils. But there's still a high number of internal assessments take place within subjects. And from those, we get an understanding of whether the pupils are capable of continuing with those courses and towards exams. And obviously, National 5 higher and advanced higher courses, and they will still have exams that they're familiar with. And target setting is something that takes place within classes and with teachers, and that's where the pupil will discuss what they expect to achieve within the course on a termly basis, and that's reflected in the reports. You'll also receive reports where we refer to what they're targeted at and also currently what they're working at. And that's just to provide some information about their strengths and also next steps moving forward. And just to finish off with assessments, also with National 5 higher and advanced higher courses, they move forward towards examinations. At Hazelhead Academy, because we do such a large number of what we call enhanced assessments in school, which are basically, if you like, mini exams that take place throughout the year, and most subjects will have 2 or 3 of these taking place within the year, we don't have actually a full prelim or mock exam diet. And that's partly because we feel we're preparing pupils more successfully by having a higher number of assessments, but also from when ESAT exams, there's no such thing of an appeal system anymore. There is actually quite a lot more pressure on the examinations for pupils than there was when we sat these courses. So we feel by giving them more assessments in these shorter bursts, we're preparing them more successfully for that final exam. And with there being no appeal system, it's not about to send any paperwork forward to the exam board and to kind of prove the level that the pupil was sitting at. It is simply on that exam and on the actual day. And the final examinations for National 5, higher and advanced higher courses, they take place, as they always have done, towards the end of April and in May. And the majority of exams actually take place in this library, with all the books moved to one side, and that's where they'll take place there. It's a nice, much airier environment than the gym hall. Okay. So that's just a bit of a quick run through the kind of qualifications framework and where the new qualifications fit within that, and also a bit of an idea of where we actually progress assessments and the assessment procedures that falling within this school. So just an opportunity to answer any questions you may have before I pass you on to our two higher education establishments, Robert Gordon's and Aberdeen University, that are with us tonight.